Hey guys, how's it? Welcome back to the Brothers of Destruction Show. I'm Razor Ryan, and this is my brother, the Berserker. So, as you guys may have noticed, Five Nights at Freddy's 4 trailer has been released. So, in honor of that happening, we're doing a Five Nights at Freddy's 1, 2, and 3 review. All in one. So guys, this video, it's going to be a long one. So sit back, get a bowl of popcorn, get your favorite drink. Chill with your best friends if you guys want to watch this. After this, play some Five Nights at Freddy's. Do everything you want. Just don't.
All I gotta say is, also rest in peace.
Get cozy and get ready, cause this is gonna be awesome. So, first of all, Scott Cawthon, I think that's even his name. I want to tell you something. First of all, after the first game happened, the internet exploded with everyone liking this game. There has been,
not to mention the Chica fan art.
There has been numerous YouTube channels dedicated to Five Nights at Freddy's, and all songs dedicated to that. So it exploded after the second and third, also exploded. So congratulations, man! Congratulations on making a sequel. So awesome.
Four sequels.
Yeah.
No, three or four.
It's almost like a. It's just like a saga.
I know, it's like Star Wars. Or The Lord of the Rings.
Never seen Lord of the Rings.
God.
So, anyway, let's start off. I want to start off with number 2. Five Nights at Freddy's 2, because it's the prequel. Yeah, you were saying?
And if you guys are wondering, no, we are not a couple. We are just friends.
Yeah, we're two bros just hanging out, just playing some video games, doing it. Those of you guys, I'm not wearing my hat
today.
I
know what you guys are thinking. You in the comment section. Delete that comment right now.
Yeah, no, don't.
The Berserker will come after you, and you will not like when the Berserker comes after you.
First of all, I know
that was not a joke for the internet either.
As you know, guys, I'm not wearing my hat. So if you guys feel bad, if you guys are mad, rage about in the comments, and everything, and let everything destroy and destruction. All you guys are done? All right, let's go. All right, so I want to do the first
Caesar time. Caesar time, Tom.
So I wanted to do Five Nights at Freddy's 2 for a first review, because, you know, it's the prequel.
This is, everybody do it a flop.
But, I'm just doing the first one. So basically, Five Nights at Freddy's 1. Scary as hell. I remember when one of my friends, when it got started getting popular, we were playing in the lunch, one of my friends was playing on his phone in the lunchroom. I had never heard the game before.
I played it once, and I died right away!
You
I died for... After a little bit.
So, what happened for me, I never played the game before. And I was watching him play, and he turned the light on in the left hallway. Bonnie was there. It scared the living shit out of me. But after a while, I started playing the game. I got up to night 7 pretty quickly. I beat night 5 and 6 on both of my second try at the first game. And I'm having troubles with 420 mode right now. So,
1987. If you type in 1987, I know.
I did.
You get the Golden Freddy head of Daryl.
I did that a couple times. Like, Golden Freddy. Boop. Okay. So, first of all, let me tell you about this
game.
Actually,
it's more of like a.
So let me first. This first the games. Let me talk about the game's lore. Still, undecided. There's been game theories out there, game theorists trying to figure out this game. So Scott, awesome job about making the internet trying to figure out what the game's lore is, and it's just incredible. So
I make the most ugly faces possible.
So guys, if you haven't heard the story before, and I don't know why, this game's been out for a couple of years now. The Five Nights at Freddy's Five Nights at Freddy's. Yeah. The whole Five Nights at Freddy's horror stuff happened when 5 children were brutally murdered in the back room.
Shame on you, Vincent.
By a guy in a costume, which has either decided supposed to be Golden Freddy's costume or Springtrap's.
Actually, I think Springtrap's later.
Game theory did say it's Springtrap. So he murdered these people in the back room, these kids in the back room, and this puppet, or the marionette, stuffed the bodies into the suits and gave them new life. Actually, marionette was the first. So, you're playing as Mike Schmidt, trying to defend yourself for 5 nights, a 6th night, and a 7th night,
Mike Schmidt is kind of a douche, though.
We don't actually don't know much about it. He doesn't talk.
It's an animation that I've seen, okay?
So, and he survives 5 nights with Freddy, Bonnie, who me and him share a special bond together because we're both lonely, Chica, Foxy, another person who me and him share a special bond because we're both lonely, and also, every now and then, Golden Freddy. And, well, first of all, let me tell you about the game's graphics. Graphics are really good. It's, like, the camera moving back and forth in some rooms, it gives that, like, little terrifying feeling. The audio noises are really good. They're there to help you out, so listen to the audio cues. But though, sometimes for me, for the first 2 nights, audio cues aren't the... You can actually play the game on the first two nights without using any without any headphones. Just turn down the volume, just nothing. Because there's nothing that big that's going to come after you. Because Freddy doesn't come into the end of the third night. Sorry, my finger, my pinky, my
you like
my, my left hand has weird, is weird with my left finger. So, my left pinky. And it's just, so basically, yeah, for me, I could do the first 2 nights with just no headphones and just do whatever. But, and it's a lot of fun. They, all different routes. My only problem, though sometimes I did run into a glitch. I was playing the seventh night. I fucked up. Freddy got into the office. I lifted the camera. I heard the entire scream. I was still on the camera thinking,
you broke the game.
What the heck?
You broke the
and
game.
And then I got...
You broke the
then
game.
Then I got jump scared again. I think it from Bonnie. I actually didn't see it. I heard the scream, and then boom, I got game over. Like,
oh, really?
Okay, then.
You broke the screen.
I thought it was pretty funny.
You broke the game.
I thought it was really funny. Stop touching my hair, son. I'll cut your hand off by the rest of my... Stop. So, back to the game. It's a lot of fun. It's really fun. The animatronics are terrifying. Well, actually, not entirely, except mostly Foxy, though. Especially when you see Foxy running the house, like, oh shit,
it's hinging jaw! It's hinging jaw! It's hinging jaw!
Bouncing up and down, like no, close it off! Oh, fucking Fox. But, a complaint I have, stop Gundam styling. One complaint I have is that most of the jump scares, they're easy to predict that's gonna happen, especially, like, for Bonnie and Chica, if you pressing the door and they don't work, you automatically know, yeah, I'm gonna get jump scared.
I'm done.
Foxy, if you see him running down the hill, you know jump scared. The only animatronic that actually has a jump scare that's like, oh shit, that just happened, is Freddy, but not like, Freddy, but not Freddy in the dark, because all of a sudden, like, you hear the noises, all of a sudden, boom, he's right in front of you.
He's like, hoo,
and I never got jump scared by Freddy, but when I played Seventh Night, just all of a sudden, boom, like, oh god. Scared the living crap out of me. But, when I did the game, I actually held Foxy in Pirate's Cove for a long time. I think he didn't get out till the sixth night. I, like, kept tabs on him. He did not peek out of his curtain until the sixth night.
Phoenix?
I watched him that frequently. Like, he didn't peek out. So I never got jump scared by Foxy. Can never find Golden Freddy, especially. But Golden Freddy is one of those rare screens. But one of the defaults I have about the game, sometimes is that the game does have some moments that is just kind of boring.
Strange.
Yeah, just some strange. That's not strange moments. Just that. Hang on, let me find my train of thought. I really like the game, but I can't find that many errors about it. The only one part I have disagree.
The phone guy.
Hello. Fucking phone guy. Every single time I hear him, like, shut the fuck up, phone guy. Shut the fuck up. Oh, it's fucking.
Don't worry. When we do our little
phone guy frustrates me. Oh my god, fucking phone guy.
Even though you do the phone guy voice perfectly.
Hello, and welcome to your new summer job at the new and improved Freddy Fazbear's Pizza.
Son of a bitch. It's like...
So yeah, phone guy... Phone guy is one of those... It's just a voice sometimes. But, it's just that... For me, the game... does get boring after a while. After you beat the first few nights, it's just like, you're kind of thinking, okay, so, yeah, I've set fourth night, woohoo, yeah. And so, after a while, it does get pretty boring. Like, jump scares will get boring pretty quickly.
Seventh night is pretty intense, I'm sure. I'm pretty sure the custom nights are pretty intense.
Yeah, but most of the time, like, just jump scares get, just get...
20-20-20-20.
Jump scares just get boring after a while. Like, just the same thing over and over. So that's Five Nights at Freddy's 1. Let's go to Five Nights at Freddy's 2. Okay.
No doors!
Yeah. Okay, Five Nights at Freddy's 2. When I saw the trailer, like, ooh, this looks awesome. This looks terrifying. By the way, Scott, one question. Why does Bonnie have no face?
What?
Where is Bonnie's face? It's like,
don't eat my face. Don't eat my face. You ate his face?
But it's just, what happened to Bonnie's face? What happened to his fucking arm?
But anyway, what happened to all their arms?
But back to Five Nights at Freddy's 2.
Just kidding.
The game takes place in 1987, as seen in your paycheck if you beat the fifth night. So, and if the game's really, it's a lot of fun. Though, for me, iPad version gets really frustrating. Especially when I run out of flashlight battery quickly. Fourth night pissed me off. Not because of Bloom Boy. When I played Five Nights at Freddy's 2, 90% of my deaths were Foxy related.
Hi.
Because two things. Few times Bloom Boy got in, and two, the battery. I could be in the fourth night, listening to the phone guy, and I'm trying to flip my flashlight, doesn't work, lose the bar already.
Damn it.
And the phone hasn't even ended, and I just flashed two times. I can't get I'm pressing it, can't get out, and I lose a bar. Instantly.
It's like, bruh.
And the phone still hasn't ended, so I get killed by 4 a.m. or sometimes 5 a.m. Foxy's nice. It's just that the phone, the flashlight battery drains like a motherfucker. And it buzzed, but this pissed me off. Also, I'm playing the sixth night. It pisses me off because I'm pressing the fucking mask button and it doesn't register. I died instantly. Chica was in there. I pressed the button. I'm like, I'm pressing the button. Finally, after when the lights start halfway flickered, and I'm done. I was pressing the button. It was not working. The mask button doesn't work sometimes. I'm pressing it and it's not going down. God fucking damn it.
Wow.
Oh. By the way,
intense rage.
Also, question, Scott, why in the sixth night does Golden Freddy come out? Why didn't he come out in the earlier nights? Was it because Phone Guy?
Yeah.
Sorry, cramp neck, guys. Is it because Phone Guy said you had a suit in the back and a yellow one? I was like, hey, Golden Freddy.
Hey, what's up, guys?
So it's just. And it's like some people got frustrated, like, oh, what? They didn't know what to do. They don't know what to do. And it's just, well,
I don't think you can do anything.
No, you can't just put the mask on immediately and hold it there. No, a different jump scare. It's also, why is Golden Freddy's jump scare just his face? It goes, ah!
It's like, why?
Done. Like,
that's not creepy. It's just weird.
It's just the head. It's just, it reminds me of the Batman.
You're just like,
it reminds me a lot of the Batman thing. Dun 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 dun.
Dun,
dun, dun, dun, dun. So, by the way,
so
back in 1987, you play as Jeremy Fitzgerald trying to survive five nights, sixth and seventh nights.
I love how you know so much about the names.
That's because I watch a lot of Markiplier. So, and you're just, and there's good no boy. Doors, no doors. So, at first, my friends was like, didn't know, like, oh god, what am I gonna do? No doors, no doors. And he got it's a lot of fun. Marionette pisses me off because he's like,
number three.
Here's the thing. In number two, like, there's more rooms.
Springtrap?
No, he's in number three.
Okay.
In number two, in FNAF 2, there's more areas. But most of your attention is just on the music area. That's all your attention because music box. So, Scott, why do you have more rooms?
It's too overpowered.
Why do you have more rooms but only still focus on one? Like, back in FNAF 1, except when on seven nights, it's also mostly Pirate's Cove, but then Pirate's Cove Snow Stage to make sure Freddy doesn't get you.
It's like, bro.
So, yeah, there's, why have more rooms and just fear? By the way, because more, there's a, there's like, there's 11 animatronics there, if you count the marionette. And, yay. And I have not gotten to 7th night. Like I said, I cannot beat the fucking 6th night. And there is, and like, the animatronics, well, here's a question. The 5th night, the toy animatronics aren't working. Why? Like, is this the old animatronics coming to you and trying to kill you? But why not the new ones? Except Mangle. Mangle's different.
Yeah.
So, and, and now the wither animatronics are there, the toy ones are there, survive 5 nights, it's a lot of fun, like, you can use your flashlight on the map to see different areas, and there's an animatronic that no one likes.
Balloon Boy.
Fucking Balloon Boy. Fucking BB. He's like, hi, hello, and he's like, shut the fuck up, Balloon Boy, shut the fuck up. Oh, and how he just goes in, when he goes in your room, but you can't turn your lights, like...
Because he steals your AA batteries.
But how does he do the door, how does he do the vent lights? That's my question.
He steals the AA batteries.
He's in there.
And that's a reference for a, thing, if you haven't seen it.
He's in there, and he's just like... And you just left it, waiting for Foxy to come jump scare, and you're just like... Fuck you, Balloon Boy. Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. There's Foxy, okay.
It's like...
Oh, fuck. Seriously, guys, what we're going to do, we're actually going to make a video. We're going to message some other YouTubers and say, hey, we're making a video. Why top 10 reasons why no one likes Balloon... Top 10 reasons why no one likes Balloon Boy. We're going to do it. But...
Use the force.
I was going to say something earlier. Oh, but seventh night, back to the seventh game, instead of just Balloon Boy, who everyone wants to just drop kick out.
Especially Master Max 888.
He did? I saw some animations, none of the animations like Balloon Boy, because I saw this one, Bonnie kicked Balloon Boy up, and he hit the ceiling. Douche. Oh, it was
fun. And that's like MLG Freddy versus Scrubs.
Oh, dude, five funky nights at Freddy's.
And that's like, Balloon
By
Boy.
By the way,
Inhale
my long enragement child. In Five Nights at Fuckboys, Balloon Boy is the ultimate evil, and you want to just want to...
He is the boss.
And then you get to kill Balloon Boy and fuck Five Nights at Fuckboys too,
and then Golden Freddy is always the final boss.
No, Golden Freddy wasn't the final boss in Fuckboys 2 or 3.
I've never played them.
Just watch Markiplier.
I do.
Yeah. And there's like 10-20 mode, and there's also different modes. There's also Golden Freddy mode, Ladies Night mode, 420 mode.
Ladies Night
mode? Yeah, there's different types of modes.
What is
modes.
Ladies Night mode?
Just basically the, Toy Chica, Mangle, Chica, and, a couple of the other toy animatronics are in that one. Also.
Dominic.
Yeah. Oh, dear. Ladies night. Alright, but here's a question. Why in the seventh night, if you put Foxy's AI on zero, he still will come out?
That's what she said.
That doesn't make any sense. Why have his AI down at zero, and yet he still comes for you?
That's what she said.
Like, shut up. Well, that's what she said. There's, the graphics. Graphics are impressive. But, I actually don't have anything to complain about the graphics. The camera will move in some different areas. The light will also brighten up some areas, in the areas in the map. So you can see, like, in the, parts and storage. Parts and storage room. You can see all the withered animatronics except Foxy. But when some very occasions, Foxy will see, like, oh, shit, what the fuck happened to you, Foxy? You got fucked. Oh.
And then there's those rare screens where you can actually see the exoskeleton of one of the animatronics, too.
Yeah, I know.
In the marionette's room.
Yeah, I know. I just don't know how to get that.
How do you do it?
I think it's rare.
Yeah. Oh, by the way, what this game includes, it includes something else that was not shown in Five Nights at Freddy's 1. Death screens. Every single, like, sometimes when you die, you get into this, like, death mini-game. There are the take cake to the children. There is the Foxy Go-Go mini. No, like,
and then there's the one where the purple guy murders the child.
No, listen. There's the, no, that's in all of them. There's the There's the one. There's the where Freddy's taking take to the children, and you play as Freddy with Cupcake. Is this like in game theory said this probably happened before the other stores? Sorry, guys. This something's happening. And you run into and you see on the outside a child crying, and Purple Kai comes up and he kills him. So that guy, it's and like, at the end, Marionette says, "What's up, bro?"
Hey,
and you die. And you die from and you die from the marionette, and Mary jumpsuits, which probably means that's the marionette. There's another one where you find it, where you play as the marionette or the puppet or from Markiplier, the baby.
Also, I have something about the marionette. You also see the child's tears, and then they dry, and then its face turns a ghost white, and then it kind of looks like the marionette a little bit.
Marionette creeps me out.
I see, and like, then let's go to the third one. Let's go to the third one.
No, dude, I'm talking about the death mini games. I got two more death mini games I'm talking about.
And then you get to see the one where the chill ghost children.
Wait, there's three more death mini games. Sorry, three more. There's another one. You play as the marionette, the baby from Markiplier, or the puppet, and you and there's these dead children. So you're walking around. So you're trying to give them. You give them gifts, and that doesn't work. Then you have to put. You stuff in the animatronics. Like there's Freddy, Foxy, Bonnie, Chica, and after that, if you see the game theory one, there's actually like he will pause it right before Golden Freddy's jump scare, and just the fifth child right in the middle. But when I'm playing the death mini games on my iPad, there is no control about it. It's like pressing it with my finger, trying to figure out what, like, the iPad version of moving it freaking frustrates me. Same with the first one, the other one. There's also the Foxy running simulated game, where Foxy runs out of, Foxy go mini game. He runs out of Pirate's Cove and goes to see his five children. And he does it two times. The third time, purple guy's right on there. He's smiling. Hey guys, what's up? You run past him, five dead children. Foxy jump scares you and says, "Fuck." He says, "Oh, bro."
Hey.
Then there's the fourth mini game where you play as Freddy in the pizzeria from FNAF 2. And you're walking and you're trying and you follow the puppet and you go. There's different areas and there's also a very, very, very rare chance in one area that like purple guy, was running towards you, and because also. In things, they're spelled, they're, if you listen
to the noises. I think that's supposed to happen.
No, there's actually sometimes, I did it a couple of times and I never got Purple Guy. I even looked for him.
Hmm.
But I forgot to mention, in the thing, there, you hear this noises and thinking, what the heck are the noises? But the game theory said, is that they're spelling out stuff like,
it's me.
No, save them, save him or her, stuff like that.
It's me.
It's stuff like that, and also just hearing the word spell out, and when purple guy gets you, screen turns black with some purple lines on the bottom. And the bottom left, right hand, left hand corner says you can't. Forgot to mention something else. If you play on the PC, there is like you're in I think the original. Another pizzeria, you play as Freddy, you're looking around,
Fazbear's Diner, I think it's called.
I think so. You're looking around, there's Bonnie right to your right, Chica to your left, you're looking around, change to different nights. The first night is just they're facing forward, second night they're looking at you, third night they're still looking at you, and at the end, you look around for your Golden Friday. Fourth night, you're looking around, and you're being, and the Bonnie and Chica, they're facing forward. They're fine. Puppet. Same. We'll get to that later. And also at the end, it says, "It's me, Mario." Woo-hoo. I'm sorry.
It's me, Mario.
You are not Mario. You are not a plumber.
I don't care.
But you are.
I'm not Italian or a plumber.
You are a very tall midget.
I know.
Okay.
I'm a giant in my mind, though.
So that's FNAF 2. FNAF 3. Let me tell the story about FNAF 3 first. This takes place after 30 years.
Can
30
I tell
years.
The story?
No. I want to tell it.
I want to tell the story.
Alright, hang on. I need to tell you guys.
I want to tell the story!
30 years ago, Freddy
talk in your Morgan Freeman voice.
I can't do Morgan Freeman!
Try. Do it in your Batman voice, son.
I'm not doing Batman voice.
Batman voice.
Batman. 30 years ago, Freddy Fazbear's Entertainment shut their doors for good, and the people, and but though the owners of Freddy Fazbear's Freddy try to relive the memory, and they bring out Freddy Fazbear's Fight the Horror Attraction, a local amusement park, and they look for someone.
And it's completely abandoned.
Shh, I'm telling the story. And you are hired as the night guard to watch over the place to make sure no one sneaks and makes out the back corner. And they have some props, but they found something on the second when you go there for the second night. They found something. The attraction has one animatronic.
And he's terrifying.
So how was that, guys? Is that kind of creepy for you? Because I thought I wanted to make creepy. So in this one, I was gonna say.
I want to say something. Damn.
Go ahead.
Well. Apparently, the backstory of this all, as usual, is that you have the purple guy, apparently, got sick and tired of the animatronics trying to kill him, so he basically bashed him up. No, I'm telling you a story.
Go ahead.
And then the purple guy took a hammer or some other blunt object. He took a blunt object. Or just something very hard hitting, and then that's where the song "I Hope You Die in a Fire" comes from. And then he goes out and proceeds to smash the living heck out of all the animatronics, freeing the spirit of the children, which chase him around. And then he finally goes in the springtrap suit, but then he doesn't know how to work it.
Fine, continue. I'm all.
He doesn't know how to work it, because he's, like, breathing heavily or something, so a thing, so, like, he's, like, laughing at them, taunting them,
I'm saying what it is.
A bolt.
The hand crank.
What is it?
Spring lock.
Yeah, the spring lock. The spring lock goes, and then... Like the exoskeleton basically closes in on him and crushes his organs and all that. So then he basically dies. A very slow and bloody death.
But that's what he's saying. There's something.
It's very
Here's tragic. The thing. If you watch the Game
if
Theory...
You want, if you want to see it, you should watch some of the animations.
If you watch Game Theory, he actually says, the purple guy is played by the phone guy. But here's the thing. Let me tell you stuff. Phone guy is the only guy who has access to who actually knows about the back rooms. He's the only one. He also worked the night shift. But here's the thing. And people said that phone guy dies the night in FNAF 1. And how would he be the purple guy? But here's the thing. I saw this thing a while ago that caught my attention. And what I saw was the purple guy in a security office. And then I started thinking, wait a minute.
Wait a second.
We hear phone guy dying from all the jump scares, but supposedly this might happen.
He's not dead.
No, because I saw this thing. The purple guy ran out and went down to the spring lock in the spring air spring trap outfit. But here's the thing. Here's what I'm thinking. Do you think this is possible? The phone guy ran out, hit himself in the back room, a place that the animatronics can't go, and hid there, and waited the next day, the night. Then when the animatronics are roaming, as you see in the death minigame, in the minigames after you beat the knights, phone guy comes out from the back room and dismantles them.
I thought it was phone purple guy who did it.
Purple guy, yeah. But think about it. Maybe purple guy did that. Maybe phone guy... It's the purple guy. He hid in the back room, waited a night, waited for the animatronics to be led by Purple Freddy, by Shadow Freddy, to the back room, where Phone Guy popped out and dismantled him. That's actually possible. But then, doing that freed the spirits, waited until you finished your shift, your week shift. That's what he did. Not the next week, because he worked the week right before you. While you were gone, the animatronics were free. Because there hasn't been a game happened after that with the animatronics still working. Because in FNAF 3, they're shadows. Think about it. Purple guy is phone guy, hitting himself in the back room, but he knows how to work the spring trap suit. Because
purple guy doesn't.
Purple guy, the reason why, because purple guy killed the children in a Golden Spawny outfit. Spring traps outfit. But though, there's also, if you watch Game Theory, it's raining. The place is old, distorted, it's in despair. And rain is seeping through the ceiling. Because you see, there's actually some blue drops falling down. If you look really closely, they're dropping. Right. And that's what happened. Because the water, and combined with the dripping and the purple guy's breathing, triggered the spring lock. That's how it happened.
Madness.
So back to the... Don't be...
Conspiracy theories galore.
That's my opinion. So back to the game. FNAF 3 is... It's awesome. It's really good. It's really good. In the first night, Springtrap doesn't show up because they haven't found an animatronic. Which is nice, because Scott actually allowed the player to look at the map. Get used to the map layout, because it's different. There's no wind, there's no doors, there's no mass, there's no nothing.
What are you doing?
There's no nothing. And you've left through these audio cues that are important. Why are you hiding behind the couch? Why? Why? Get it back over here. Come here, son. So, he doesn't show up in the first night. Second night, he comes out. And also, there's also different things to focus about. Ventilation, audio, and camera. Because if your camera goes out, you're like, oh shit, reboot, re-fucking-boot. Because there's two areas. There's the map right to your left, and there's the maintenance panel right next to you.
Yeah.
And there's also vents in the place. It's different. It gets
the nightmare animatronics.
No, that's what's coming soon. I'm talking about FNAF 3.
Or the Phantom animatronic.
Yeah, I'll get to that. And so after you beat the first night, the second night rolls in. After you do the minigame, but there's also hidden mini games. That if you go down to the left corridor, left hand corridor, up like after you go to the security office, go up to the. There's different things. Like as you can see, and Markiplier does the All Secrets Revealed thing. How to get the good ending? Because there's two endings, bad and good, which I'll get to later.
Bruh.
So anyway, after when you get in the second night, Springtrap is there. And the ventilation will go out if you're not keeping tabs on it. And with Springtrap, he's a tricky bastard. What you gotta do is use the audio, because Phone Guy states in all the stuff that these spring animatronics are known to going to places with noises. So you play, by the way, you all had to play it in the room right next to him. Otherwise, if you do it too far away, he's not gonna hear it. You gotta do it right next door. Right next to him, because I've seen some other people play it, and they're doing like over there, and he's right there. No, it's gotta be right next to him. That's what's best. And you'll go for the vents, and also there's Phantom Balloon Boy, Phantom Chica, Phantom Foxy, Phantom Freddy, and Phantom Marionette. Am I missing any? Oh, Phantom Angle. By the way, where's Phantom Bonnie? Is the reason why he's not in there because the Spring Trap's supposed to be Bonnie? That's why, because
he might be Golden Bonnie.
Yeah, true, but
thing.
Yeah, but like maybe there's only supposed to be one Bonnie. I think Springtrap was supposed to be that Bonnie. So I don't know. I did see some animation. People doing like Phantom Bonnie. Whoosh! Okay. By the way, for me, when I first saw the Phantom animatronics, I thought, oh god, I'm dead.
I'm dead.
Oh shit! I'm still alive. How am I still alive?
And then it's blinking lights.
Blinking light. I'm like. Hyperventilating, my screen's going dark, going up and down, and they're like, fix. Oh, hi, Springtrap. By the way, if Springtrap's in your door, or right in front of you, just say, hey, let's talk to him. Except if he's right in the window, immediately, if you see him in the window, go to your camera, go to number two, do an audio cue right in number two. You got to. Otherwise, you do this long, the ventilation will go out at any time.
bro.
And if you, and if, like, all of a sudden you're talking, dude, I'm dead. So you go, I'm fixing it. So if you're fixing it, you're going to go, boop, and you go, ooh, that bitch was peeking. Oh, by the Dashy Games, awesome. So.
Damn it, Dominic.
Sorry, I had to do that. And this, the animatronics, the fans of animatronics are different because they're, because some of them have triggers. Oof. Bloom, Chica's in one area, Bloom Boy's just everywhere, Phantom, the puppets in one area, Freddy will just go boop, front of it. So what you gotta do is go to your screen, just go back and forth, don't let him go down, if don't let him go down, or just go to the camera and just stay in there. Don't go in the stay in the camera too long, because otherwise it'll go, excuse me. Wow. Camera error, gotta go and fix it. Right, also, make sure Springtrap doesn't get close. But also in the game, Springtrap, it's sometimes kind of a little tricky to find, because I had troubles with finding him in Cam 1, as in Cam 10, Cam 1. Because I didn't notice he was right under the map. I didn't notice that, and like, oh. Hi. By the way, do not bring him in camera 1. Do not bring him in camera 10, as in the far camera, or in camera 2, without shutting down the vent. Because if he does, if you do not do it, you're dead. It's going to happen. By the way, what triggers Phantom Foxy? What triggers him?
I think they're just random.
Yeah, just all of a sudden, boom, he's there. Like,
bro.
Hi. Hi, Foxy. I love you.
By the way, from Marionette. If you guys remember me talk
give
saying,
give Daddy a hug.
Whoosh, dead. If you guys remember what I said in FNAF 2, this is like you're moving like in the thing. Always puppet. The puppet jump scare in this one is does not jump at you. It follows you, beeping loudly in your head like shut up. He's in there for a while. And by the way, your screen doesn't go black scene. It kind of goes into this really dim light. Really dim. But you can still see.
Okay.
But it's still hard. It's still kind of hard. So, graphics are pretty good. Really good.
I am iron hard.
Scott, why in that panel? The panel in the... Right under the window, there's like, boop, like, type in a number. 395248, if I remember the number correctly. Yeah, I have a good memory.
395-28.
395-248, which goes into this other minigame, which also, after you get into like, these little codes, like these little stuff, when you're walking down a corridor, they bring you these little minigames. Why do you gotta glitch the minigames? Scott, why do you gotta glitch things?
Why you gotta do that?
Why do you gotta... This doesn't make any sense.
Come on.
To get the good ending, you gotta find the children, because you gotta get them... Do the Mangle one first. Mangle's quest. Get the cake. When he plays the other animatronics, you have to give cake to the children, which helps free their souls. So here's the thing. If you don't do the minigames, and you beat the game, to go through all 5 nights... You get this thing called the bad ending. But you see the heads of the animatronics with their eyes still on. Meaning those kids' souls are still in there and they're not been put to rest. And they will haunt you to the end of this. Which, by the way, I don't know if FNAF 4 takes place earlier or soon or earlier after Frasmus fight or before.
I kind of like how they do that.
Was it before or after FNAF 1?
I don't know.
Because I see the Nightmare animatronics, and my thing was... I was wondering...
Way after.
The thing is, are those kids' souls still in them? Did people assume they got the bad ending? And they're still trying to kill kids. They're still going to kill them.
Hold on, I want to say something.
Go ahead.
I kind of like how they did the thing with, like, Five Nights at Freddy's 1 and 2. Like, they did the... sequel before prequel. The prequel.
Yeah.
It's yeah. Like, but it it's, also it's makes really it confusing.
It's really nice because there's a lot of movie, yeah. There's a lot of stuff out there. But example, one of the best movies
kind of
prequel that sequels that were a prequel is The Godfather. Godfather, man.
You're obsessed with that?
Because the movies are fucking awesome. Godfather 2, Part 2, takes place before Godfather 1.
You may thump me on the head because I've never seen it.
By the way, guys, if you have not seen The Godfather, watch it. Watch it now. Stop this video. Watch it. I don't know how. What the fuck was that? That was a screech.
That was a banshee.
Stop being mangled.
I want to be mangled.
No, you don't. Nope. 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 Nope.
So, nope. 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 So much. Nope.
If you get the mini games, you get the good ending.
Laughing Jack.
Which the animatronics are still on the ground, but the lights are not on. By the way, Golden Freddy's in the bad ending. Like he's on the disc. He's in the back. His lights on. But if you get the good ending, he's not.
I'm a pretty little butterfly.
But here's the thing. After Phone Guy, I'm not calling him Purple Guy, I'm calling him Phone Guy. Phone Guy gets all the animatronics. He got 4. But stop being a butterfly.
I am a butterfly.
If there's 4, he dismantled 4 animatronics. But
I'm a pretty little butterfly.
But here's a question. Once you got to the fifth night, there's a fifth child. Like, where did you come from? Is the fifth child supposed to be Golden Freddy marionettes? Which one?
Maybe.
Doesn't make any
Unless
sense.
One of the mothers is supposed to be the marionette.
No, marionette was a child.
I don't care! How do you know?
Game theory!
How do you know this?
We're watching Game Theory. Okay. So, where did this fifth kid come from? That's the question. Because the 4 animatronics were dismantled, but the fifth one was never seen.
He's probably Golden Freddy.
Yeah, but where did the kid come from? Purple guy, phone guy, did not dismantle Golden Freddy. So where did he come from? By the way, after you beat the fifth night, sixth or seventh. There's a thing called Nightmare Night, which gets back, which brings back into reason how phone guy got the Golden Bonnie outfit, because he said that the Spring Bonnie outfit has been moved to a different area due to many spring lock failures. Yeah. Man, I have a good memory.
Dang.
And Nightmare Night is also really hard. And then there's, if you get the good ending,
Why he's the genius of the group.
If you get the good ending,
I'm just a hard hitter, he's the brains.
You guys are both hard hitters.
I am the one bred for hard hitting, though.
True. I am bred for it. The good ending has aggressive nightmare mode, which is borderline hard. It's everything is coming at you. What? Stop doing that. By the way, because Dream Chap will go.
I'm glitching now.
Hello.
I'm glitching.
Okay, so we talked about the games, all 3 games. So time for the review. For NAF 1, we are giving an 8 out of 10. It's really good. Some
kinda
parts.
Cheesy.
Yeah. FNAF 2, we're giving a 5 out of 10 because there was a lot of parts, a lot of things that kind of frustrated a lot of people. Especially with the iPad. That's why I'm giving it a 5 out of 10 because of the iPad. For FNAF 3, we're giving it a 7 out of 10. Now, these are mobile games. So, by the way, so that's our 3
What about
reviews.
The PC version?
PC versions, we don't have PC.
10 out of 10!
No, for PC, we're giving all 8 out of 10. Because, like I said, there is some stuff that is still not there. This needs to be better.
Take your hat, sir.
So, so that's a review, but I want to say something. I want to say this is a really good idea. Scott, I think this is a really good idea. I think you might like this. If you're watching this. During different nights, like if you have different more animatronics, different nights have them like different jump scares every night, keeping that fear going. Also,
one time you could have them wielding a butcher's knife,
have one like just jump at you. Thrower. Have another one like have one
the
night they jump scare you at the front. Another night that they come up behind you, pull you around, and just attack you. Like pull you around, and just attack you right there. But here's another idea. This actually would be really good.
Five Nights at Anime?
No. Because all the animatronics have a significant route. But what would be really, really good is if when you do the animatronics, have them, like, different nights, have them take different routes, and have one at the fifth night, Let them go wherever you want. Let them, and also, if you don't, make sure they don't, the people don't have a solid strategy all the way through.
Nine!
No, because have the animatronics just fuck up your strategy. It's like, they take one round, you think that like they will adapt to your strategy. Like, you'd say they're going to be in one, this area. No, they will, they fuck it up. They'll just go in a different area.
And then you can have a secret door behind you that they can...
Yeah, have that. Have, like, a different route. That have a different route, an alternate route that you have to... It's hard to find. Also, if you have, like, for the game, like, if you did, like, another noise game, horror game, have them, like, like, this one area, this have them have them take out the camera and the audio, and you can't play audio and on that room. So it's hard for them, like, in the room right next to it. You have to be in the room right next to it. And they're right there, and they just take off one of them, and they're right by you. Have some of that. Have them, like, take out the areas, take out the audio and the camera, making preventing you from doing anything for that room. Have them do that. Make sure they also tell you players that they can't have the animatronics in a specific room at all times. Otherwise, they will take out the camera and just mess it up. This thing, for me, I don't know much about gaming. I'm admitting that. We don't know much about gaming.
Do you care about that?
Yeah, I don't know how to make a good video game. But these are just ideas that I just came. So if you want to, try them out. See what you think. See, like, hey, try, maybe I should, maybe let me change this up. So guys, that is our review. That is for this episode. Hopefully we'll be saving up our money to get a PC. Get a webcam, get some microphones, and we will be doing a Let's Play of Five Nights at Freddy's 4. We will. And you get to see us flip fucking out. And by the way, our strategy, every single time one of us dies, we switch.
Mostly
we're going to be dying a lot, dude.
You're gonna be the one freaking out. I'm just going to
yeah,
be
like, yeah, there might be some parts that me
this is gonna flying be out of chair. This is going to be my face the whole time.
Okay, so that is our review. Anywho, so thank you guys all so much for watching. Thanks for taking the time to watch our review. We're actually one of the very few people who actually would do a 5 minutes of Freddy's review. I researched just before. Stop. I actually researched before, like, how many people did a 5 minutes of Freddy's review. Not many people. Not many people at all do Five Nights at Freddy's review. Like, let's do it.
What are you guys doing with your life?
So, guys, thank you so much for watching. Check out the other games we have cool reviews cats. On. Please comment on us if you guys like this. Like us on Facebook still. Watch our other reviews, like I said. And, yeah, so we will see you guys very soon. Stay fierce and...
Berserker out.
Razor out. See you guys.